Hello everyone, this video is about getting help in Linux. How can you find extra help or to remember some commands and how to get to know the options? If you are here for the first time, please see the previous videos in this playlist, which is Linux for Computer Science Students. Okay, so before I get started, you have to remember that there is no magic in Linux. Everything is written, saved somewhere, and your task is to understand where is this file and how it works and where this file is saved, just in case if you need to refer to this file directly. Okay, and let's start with now, like let's do the lab of chapter 6. And before we do this, let's do it in this way. So okay, so let's close this and put that one here and then this one here, and now we start our own Ubuntu terminal, and here we are going to implement the tutorial here related to this chapter. All right, so the first, like, let's assume that I have to use a command called date, that we have used it in the previous videos, and this is to display, if you write it like this, then you will see the date of the current time. And remember, we use the form of the command and then option or options and then the argument. This is the style, or this is the rule that you would like to write, give a command in Linux. All right, so how can I know more information or options related to the date? So you have, of course, you can use the Google, you can use ChatGPT to query about the specific task. But since you are a Linux and a computer science student or a researcher, then you need to know how to find yourself directly inside Linux itself. Imagine that you are inside a server and you are now a system administrator, and then you need to remember exactly how the command works. So, and you don't have a GUI, so you don't, you only have this black screen, you don't have a GUI, then you can search. It's not impossible nowadays. You can have your tablet, or you have another computer connected to the internet with GUI, then you can search and write the commands. This is totally fine. I agree with this. It's a good solution, but you, like, it would be nice if you know how to find help through this command line interface or CLI. This is a black screen, it's called CLI. All right, or command line interface. So one of the commands that used to find a help is called man, which is for manual. So if you type man date, then you will see here the name of the command, what it does. It actually prints or set the system date and time. Here you have a description, and here we have the options. For minus D, you can use it in to display time described by the by string, or you can use two time to minus date. This is the full version, and this is the shortcut. All right, so to navigate in this page, you can use the arrow low in the keyboard or up, or also you can use the space to change the pages. Okay, if you search, for example, you have to know, for example, minus R. So here you can see there, you press backslash and then you type minus R. You are searching for this option, and automatically it highlights up where it, you can find minus R inside this page. Minus R, this is what I am needing, or it refers to reference, and here it displays the last modification time of file. If I want to close this page, the manual page, then you press Q in your keyboard, or as it's given here, press H for help or Q to quit. Okay, so you quit it with this time, with this, then you return back to the main CLI. Here, what is I am explaining about. And here, if you press help, this is, it shows you how to navigate. However, I don't think you need to know this, but it's fair enough if you go move up, down, Q, and that's it. And this is how you make a search, that in the same way I did, my mandate, and then here file, and here you can find the files there. Okay, and this is what I'm talking about. This is how to close, and let me explain something also important here. I think the question you have got yourself now, there is a date, and what is this one here? Why it's one? Actually, here it means that this is page number one from Linux system. In Linux, there are generally 9 pages, and they are written here. So there are different manual pages for this are distinguished by sections. By default, there are 9 sections in main page or in Linux. The first one is about executable programs and shell commands. So the first one is about the commands that you are using to execute something in Linux, and that's why referring to the date. So date now, it's about the command that is used to executable program. Also, there is another one for system call, the library call, and this is 3, and as you will see, I will refer to them, or you will see them later. Okay, so for example, let's assume, this is not a very important thing, let's assume that we have a command called password, and this is a command that is used to change the password or modify a password for a user. So let's see the manual of this password, and it's again 1. So there is a command in page 1 that is used to change user password. Okay, but this is a bit tricky because in Linux there are many pages contain the command password. To know them, I quit now and I say man minus f pages, and it says now there is the first one, there is a password command in page one, number 1, which is executable programs for or shell commands, and there is another one in page number 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is about file format and conventions, as you can see here. And this is change user password, this is a command, and another one, there is a file for passwords in the system. All right, so now if you press man minus like this by default, then Linux will come and search for the first. Remember, no magic in Linux. So if you do it like this, then Linux will come and search the pages one by one. Is it there? Yes, password is there. Then you will see the default value 1, which is about in page 1, that you are now reading a information or a help for the command in the first page. All right, what about if you would like to read information about the 1 in the 5, in page number 5, then simply you refer to 5 here. And as you can see here, now you have 5. This is the password file, and here you have the information, and here you have everything about you need to know about this file. All right, so now I think this is what I'm doing. This is what I have done. And I think you have a question now. How can I know how many pages or how many commands in different pages? So now how could I say that there is a password in minus f password and change? I print them out. You can do this one, minus f, or you can simply say what is password. And as you will see, the same output as it's here. Man minus f, it's fair enough if you know this command, and that's okay, but it would be nice if you know something else. But this one is fair enough. Man minus f, and then you put the command. Okay, let's see. Man minus f. And there is a command called cb that you will see later. In this system, there is only one command, which is in page 1 for managing files and executable some commands. They are here, which is with this cb belongs to this page, which is about copy file and directories. Okay, so again, man rm for remove, and also minus f. All right, there is also one in the same in the first page for remove files or directories. Okay, so this is what about the man. Also, there is another command called info, which does the same as the man, but if you know man, I'm pretty sure that's the best. But it's sometime if some other users would like to show that they have used something else, for example info cp, then you will see something similar. And I recommend you, here you can quit again, I recommend you can only use man, and that will be fair enough. Okay, here you can see how to navigate through the page for the manual page. For example, if I say man CP, then I see now I can move down, I can move up, and then I can quit with the Q letter in the keyboard. There's also a help, not like this, CP, then you use help, like this. And here you get some information, the same information as is with info help, info CP. Alright, this is what you find your information, and also remember, no magic in Linux. So there are some documents, they are served here. Let's say ls, and then under the root, there is a folder called user or directory. Under user, there is a folder called share. By the way, if you just type few letters and then you best press the tab in your keyboard, then it will be automatically completed. And then you use doc. And here you have many documents for more help about some other commands. For example, you can see here almost some of the commands that are available. The documentations for the commands are available in this directory, user share document. All right, then I think to find the file, you can use the locate command. However, this is not an important command. I will show you later. There is another command called find, which is more quietly used than locate. Locate is faster, but it needs to refresh the system frequently. And that's all in this session. Also, if you need to know, according to this, no magic in Linux, and if you need to know, if I say man password, then where this file is stored, actually you can use a command called where is password, and as you can see, the password, the first one is here, and then the second one here, and the what information is going to be from the first one is here. If you remember, if I say man minus f password, then you will see the first one is going to be here, and then this is related to this one, and then n5, and you can go to check if it's there or not. So if you type ls and then you select this, and then right click in your keyboard and click here, it will be automatically copy pasted here. So again, if I would like to copy paste all the line this, then you just select it, right click on the mouse, and then right click here. Okay, do you see this trick? This is one of the tricks in Linux. Now I would like to list only this path, then right click here, and then right click here, and then you will see the file is there. Okay, let's see ls minus l. If I see now, this is a file, not a directory, as I mentioned in the previous video. And here you have the permission, the owner, or the user, and then when it's modified. Okay, with this, I end this session, and I will see you in the next video. Please do the chapter exam in the NetAcad or in this course.